Good morning, students. I am Pavan, your science master. Today I would like to speak to 6th standard students. Students, in the previous class we have talked about magnetic materials, non-magnetic materials, separating iron filings from soil, poles of magnet. Students, I hope you are doing the given assignment. Today's learning objectives are finding the directions with a bar magnet, magnetic compass, attraction and repulsion between two magnets, like and unlike poles. You remember these points. Till the end of this lecture, you will be able to understand these points. Do you know how sailors and pilots reach their destination? And do you know directions of Earth? To understand these points, let us do a lab activity. The aim of this lab activity is to find the directions of Earth with a bar magnet. The operators needed to do this activity: bar magnet, thread, and stand. The procedure to be followed to do this activity: suspend a bar magnet freely with the help of a thread around its center as shown in the figure. And try to answer for these questions. Now, does the magnet remain stationary? What will you observe after some time? Finally, you will observe that the magnet takes a position in the north and south direction. Now, mark the end of the magnet showing towards the north with red color. Now, once again disturb the magnet and observe the magnet until it comes to rest. Does the red mark end of the magnet take position towards north direction? Repeat the experiment for several times at different places and observe, does the red mark end of the magnet take position towards north direction? What will you observe? Observation. You will observe the bar magnet comes to rest in the north and south direction. Now, what will be the conclusion of this lab activity? Conclusion. Magnets always come to rest in the north, south direction. In each case, the marked end points towards north. This end is known as north pole of the magnet. The other end, which points towards south, is known as south pole of the magnet. This property of magnets is called directional property. This property is used in magnetic compass. Now we have completed the first today's objective, and next today's objective is magnetic compass. What is magnetic compass? A compass is usually a small box with a glass covering it. A magnetized needle is pivoted inside the box in such a way that it can rotate freely. The compass also has a dial with directions marked on it. The compass is kept at a place where we wish to know the direction. Its needle indicates the north and south direction when it comes to rest. The compass is rotated until the north and south marked on the dial are exactly below the ends of the needle. To identify the north pole of the magnet or magnetic needle, it's usually painted in a different color. Then we identify north and south at that place. After that, we can also identify the east and west between them. A compass is used to find directions. It's mostly used in ships and aeroplanes. Mountaineers and army people also carry a magnetic compass with them so that they do not lose their way in unknown place. And while you are using a magnetic compass, there is a note you should remember that. Don't place the magnetic compass closer to another magnet. If you do like this, the needle in the magnetic compass may get disturbed by the other magnet outside the magnetic compass, and you may get a wrong direction, the wrong direction by the magnetic compass. Students, let us understand another concept of this lesson, attraction and repulsion between two magnets. I have told you, do not keep a magnetic compass nearby another magnet, because the magnetic compass needle may get disturbed by the other magnet because of attraction and repulsion between two magnets. So, to understand attraction and repulsion between two magnets, you have to do an activity. Take two similar magnets, place them in four different ways as shown on the screen. What do you observe? When do the magnets attract each other? When do the magnets repel each other? Repel means they do not come close. They move away when they come close. Then you will notice that if you bring two magnets close in such a way, north pole of one magnet and same north pole of another magnet, they do not come close and they repel. They move away. North and north or south and south of two different magnets are called like poles. North and south or south and north of two different magnets are called unlike poles. Students, here you can understand like poles of two different magnets always repel and unlike poles of two different magnets always attract. So this is how we can understand what are attraction and repulsion between two magnets. Students, the summary of this lecture is We have talked about finding the directions with bar magnet and what is magnetic compass, attraction and repulsion between two magnets, like and unlike poles. Students, I hope you understood the points that we have talked now. Then I would like to give you an assignment that to write the lab activity finding directions. To write what? The lab activity finding directions that I have given you in this lecture. If you don't understand, you repeatedly watch it, you will definitely understand, and you write it in your notebook. This is for today's students. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.